So this past Christmas, I was in Colombia, and it was really, really awesome. And we spent like the entire time just roaming around the streets of Bogota and Medellin. And we stayed up till like 6 a.m. one morning, and there was this band playing in the streets, and it was amazing. And we just sort of did all of this really cool stuff that that I can't even begin to tell you about. It was really, really awesome. Hey, what are you drawing over there?
Just a
lock under
your face.
Oh man, I need some help. I better call AVID.
Hello? Okay, we'll be there.
He's a little bit of old school for it. That goes a little something like this. Always trying to be the flyest kid on the block. The popular one with the rising stock. So that's when I had this bright idea.
For the party of the month.
Now the party of the year. All the fine girls couldn't turn it down. Now all I gotta do is get my parents out. Should I send them to a movie?
Send them to a show.
Let me think. It's gotta be long though.
Don't fear.
AVID is.
Have a good time. The doorbell rings because the party's here. I'm cranking up the stereo like it's New Year's. Walking around the house like I'm the man.
Anybody do it like Eric can.
Alright, so we're taking notes today. I want you guys to go from top all the way to the bottom and then write as concisely as you can. And we'll turn them in.
And I'm gonna teach you guys how to take better notes. No more kitty cats, no more calculators, no more origami. And you, sir, need to start breathing. We are gonna learn a whole new format of note taking, okay?
So the proper way to draw cats to add nice, pointy little ears and soft little eyes so you know you can trust it. Every once in a while, you just might wanna add it a little tiny
goldenrod and the 4-H stone.
Bow tie, right?
Things I brought you when I found out you had cancer.
That's how you properly take notes.
Very good, very good. That's a good job.
Your father cried on the telephone and he drove his car into the neighbor.
Not what you did. Start over.
Hello, Eastlake. I'm Trent Rudkin, and I'm better than Mr. Johnson. I'm here today to explain to you what AVID is. And I'm here with Gray. Gray, I'm going to ask you a couple questions about AVID.
All right.
What aspect of AVID do you feel best prepares you for college?
I'd say the note-taking, because it is basically what you get from your lectures, and without that, I mean, you have no success.
Awesome. Interesting. Now, what is the way that you guys take notes? Is there some kind of system to this?
Yeah, the Cornell note format.
And what is the Cornell note format?
It's basically just your everyday two column notes, and you have the left side, you have the main points of the discussion, and then the right, you have the more detailed portion.
Gotcha. All right. Very interesting. So, you've been in the AVID program for how long now?
About a semester.
Semester. Gotcha. I love it when I watch those semesters. So, do you find that that you also have enough time in the program to work out?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, working out is essential. I couldn't go without it.
I think it's pretty obvious. So, Gray, managing through all the tasks and responsibilities of AVID, do you ever, you know, find time to get alone, or do you have a significant other?
Actually, I kind of have a girl I'm talking to.
Uh-huh. Right. Cool. Cool. Yeah, me too.
Yeah,
me too.
Yeah, that's cool.
There's a lot out there. Efficiency. So, you know, prom's actually right around the corner. Did you already plan on going to prom?
Nah, she doesn't want to go.
She Cool. Well, I mean, you know, I'm not doing anything either that day.
Yeah, probably.
So you can call me or we'll just Facebook. Yeah. Cool. All right. Well, hey, it was great meeting you, Greg, and thanks for interviewing with me.
No problem.
So, Christian, do you feel that AVID has helped you with the love life and the ladies?
I mean, yeah, I think so. You know.
Hey there. I'm here with Jenny. Jenny, how long have you been in the AVID program?
I've been in it for 3 years.
3 whole years. Wow. And how do you feel that the program has improved you as a student in a whole?
It's actually helped me, especially with the note-taking. I actually know how to take better notes than I did my freshman year. Mm-hmm. So yeah, that's helped me.
Really? So you're saying that you retain a lot more information better through your note-taking method?
Oh, definitely, because once when we take the notes, towards the very end, we're supposed to summarize what we did. So when you go back to actually like review your notes, you can just study your summary instead of rebooting the whole entire notes.
And that's part of the Cornell method?
Yes, it is.
Okay, very interesting, very interesting. So this program, AVID, does it take up a lot of your free time?
No, not necessarily. I mean, if you put a lot of work into your studying and everything, and then the way that you do the method that we have been taught in the program, it should go smoothly.
Awesome, awesome. So you're saying that if you're diligent with it, with your work, that you'll still have time for social outings and things. That's very interesting. So a social outing could be, you know, like prom or a date or something. Do you have any current plans for prom?
I do.
You do? Oh, that's interesting. So it's like you're going with like some guy, right?
Yeah, you can say that.
Yeah? Cool. Yeah. That's, hey, good for you. Good for you. Awesome. All right. Well, it's been a pleasure interviewing you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Mm-hmm. All right. My name's Jeff Brown, and we have Jessica Webb with us today. She's going to tell us a little bit about AVID tutoring. So tell us, Jessica, what do you do as an AVID tutor?
Well, basically, my role is to facilitate the tutorials on Tuesdays and Thursdays here and to basically guide the students to come to an understanding of their own problem, but without just giving them the answers to it. And along with that, we also, we're like mentors to the kids. Like, they are supposed to look up to us, and we help them with like anything they need to, like the college process, stuff like that.
What's your basic form for tutoring the students? What do you do? Like, do you just like get into groups and all that, or?
Yeah, we usually split them up with subjects. Like, maths will be one subject, science in the other, and they go through their POCs and they write down like what their problem is and their point of confusion, and then we ask questions to help them think critically and try and figure out their answer.
I'm here with Linda, who's been a part of AVID. How long have you been with AVID?
2 years.
2 years, okay. So could you tell me again real quick, what does AVID actually stand for?
It means Advancement Via Individual Determination.
Okay, and you like this program?
Yeah, I really do.
Yeah, okay, that's awesome. What, in your mind, would you like to see happen with the program in the next few years?
Expanding with more students and more determination, like, being able to do things on their own without help of other people.
Okay. So what kind of students would you suggest would be good for this program?
Students who are interested in going to college and pursuing careers and trying to find ways to benefit themselves in college.
Okay. Because this program is preparing students for college, yeah? Okay. Awesome. Well, thank you so much for your time.
Eric.
I don't know how to do that.
Are we filming?
Are we?
I'm here with Mr. Obartuck, the AVID coordinator for Eastlake High School. Mr. Obartuck, how long have you been with Eastlake High School?
As a teacher or as the AVID coordinator?
As a teacher.
You said at Eastlake, right? This is my 8th year here at Eastlake.
8th year?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. And so you are an English teacher, obviously, not a math teacher? Yeah?
Why are you going to ask me the question and answer it for me?
Well, I mean, I was just pointing out the obvious that you can't count. So how long have you been a coordinator of AVID?
This is my first year as the AVID coordinator.
First year. So what is your vision or goal for AVID in the next couple of years?
What I would like to see AVID continue to shape to is the advanced program that it is, and it supports the work that the kids are doing in the other classes. So what I would like to see is more coordination amongst the great staff that we already have, so that we can better support those kids and not just get them ready to enter college, but give them the tools necessary so they can be successful and graduate college.
Gotcha.
Okay.
So what kind of students would you suggest enroll in this program?
I'm not mocking you. You can do better than that. I'm just saying, like, I kind of look at the lens a lot.
The lens?
The lens.
Oh.
Yeah. It's kind of weird.
Okay, so wait, turn that. Okay. The ideal AVID student would be anyone who has the individual determination, that drive to be successful, to challenge themselves, and to take the opportunity to be a self-motivated learner and value the support that we're offering and that the other students in the program can offer.
All right.
Okay. Mr. Obartuck, did you know that FSU students and UF students actually do have something in common?
What?
So, Mr. Obartuck, are there any qualifications or requirements to get into this program?
Yes, Kelly. There are requirements to get into the program. One is you cannot be Mr. Morris.
Obviously.
And some of the others, we want to see students who are generally in that mid to upper range as far as achievement. And again, we want to see students that have that individual determination. So they want to learn, they want to come and participate in class and put in that work now that'll pay off later.